Hello everybody and welcome back to the Metal Scrapper channel. So today let's talk about crucibles. These are the crucibles I use, and when I started melting I had this kind of crucibles. This is a brand new one. I ordered this from China, and this is clay graphite. These are fairly cheap, but they will last at most 10 melts, I guess, and then they will crumble apart. So I was starting to use some other kind of crucibles. This is the one I use for the copper, and this has been in use for at least 10 melts. You can see this crucible is starting to glossify. So this is a mid-range crucible. This is exactly the same crucible. It has a little crack here, I know. This is a mid-range crucible, and I'm not really excited about these crucibles. This one lasts a long time, but I had the same one where the bottom exploded first while preheating the crucible or tempering the crucible, but this one is it's doing its job quite well. So this is the exact same one, only this is a 8 kilo crucible. This is the biggest crucible I have, but I see some bad spots already after one use. So I think the problem is I did not temper this on the correct manner. So now you see I have another new crucible. This is a 6 kilo crucible, slightly smaller than this one, but this is the top of the line in my opinion, I guess. I still have to use it. This is a Salamander Super Crucible. So this is quite expensive. It's double the price of the mid-range, and this is four times the price of a cheap one. So don't want to damage this one for the first melt. You can clearly see the quality difference in the crucibles. So how do we properly temper a crucible? Well, if you go to the website of Morgan Advanced Materials, can I focus? Yeah, Morgan Advanced Materials. You can or here it is. So here's the website, www.morgansmms.com. You can search for the Salamander Super Crucible and you will see a first use schedule. It's a PDF file. So what I'm going to do, this one will go first into the oven inside the house. I will slightly heat it up until 200 degrees Celsius in 2 hours, so it's 25 degrees Celsius per 15 minutes. And if that's done, I will gradually heat it in the melting furnace to 600 degrees Celsius. When that point is achieved, it will start to get red glowing hot. I will bring it up to the temperature where it's melting point for the metal you want to use. Always use one kind of metal per crucible. This particular crucible I bought for copper. So I will temper this crucible at 1100 degrees. I have to keep it at 30 minutes at 1100 degrees. And after that, I will the best way to start using is to directly charge your crucible with the metal you want to melt. I think I'm running out of propane at that time, so I will go to the propane store, get a new bottle, and who knows? So stay tuned for my channel to see something with copper, I guess. Right, let's temper this one. Alright guys, so just got the crucible out of the oven inside. Has been heating to up to 200 degrees for 2 hours, slowly increasing the temperature. So now I have the regulator of the propane tank. I have it at its lowest point, so I'll make a fire inside the furnace and gradually build up the pressure and thus the heat. I also have my, so I will now slowly increase the pressure and thus the heat. I have my infrared thermometer ready. I will first heat it up to 600 degrees. After that we can open it up and get the temperature up to the copper melting point. It's 1100 degrees, and it should be at 1100 degrees for 30 minutes. Then the crucible is ready for its first use. So first, let's start to make a fire now. I got it at very low pressure, so hope this will work. Right, so very low pressure, open the air choke just a little bit. I'll now insert the crucible. Alright, so you can see the pressure is very, very low. Right, for the first couple of minutes I will have the lid open so it can gradually build up in temperature, and I will measure the temperature with the infrared thermometer. I'm measuring the inside of the crucible and it's around 200. That's correct because it just came out of the furnace, out of the oven. Right, so 1 minute in, it's 100 degrees hotter, so that's good. It's 100 degrees Celsius per minute is a great way to increase temperature. Two minutes in, 200 degrees more, so going pretty good. Minutes in, 500 degrees. Alright, it's 4 minutes in, it's just over 600 degrees, so I'll close the lid and we'll increase the temperature slightly up to 1100 degrees. So first let's increase the pressure. Always make sure to turn it clockwise to increase pressure. Now I'll close the lid. Right now we constantly check the temperature. 700 degrees, a minute later. Right, so we just hit the 700 degree mark and we'll slightly increase the pressure to 0.02. We're 6 minutes in and slowly starting to rise to 800 degrees. 7 minutes in should be 900 degrees, a little bit under, so we'll increase the pressure. So the second step, increasing the pressure just a little bit, should get it up to about 1000 degrees. Right, we're 8 minutes into the preparation of the crucible, starting to get glowing. Don't know if you can see that, but starting to get a little bit red hot now. So let's check temperature. Slowly getting there, 914 degrees Celsius. Right, 9 minutes in, it's getting really red hot right now. Let me show if you can see that. I think it shows a little bit on the screen. It's all red colored right now, so it's beautiful. Let's check the temperature. It should be around 1100 degrees. We're just over 1000 degrees, so I will increase the pressure for the last time. And we'll now have it steady for 30 minutes at 1100 degrees.
So we're slowly moving to the 1000 degrees. To get it on just over 1000 degrees, we'll increase the pressure a little bit again. So I think this will do the job. 0.06, I guess. Yep. All right, we're 10 minutes in. You can clearly see that it's glowing red hot. We'll keep it at this temperature for 30 minutes now. It's looking great, just around 1100 degrees. Alright, so to reach the 1100 degrees, like I said, we'll increase the pressure a little bit. This should do the job. We're a little bit over, so I will a little bit decrease pressure. Alright, 5 minutes, a little bit too high, but the pressure is dropping because the bottle is almost empty. Right, like I just said, the pressure is dropping a little bit. It's also starting to freeze up. So, got my second bottle here, ready to attach that one. So far still going good, but if this one is totally empty or frozen up, we'll change this, and this is almost a almost empty bottle, so I guess I will get two new bottles. Right, so 10 minutes now, just over 1100, it's okay, almost 1200, but steady at 1200 degrees, so 100 degrees over what I wanted, but still happy. But so far, still going strong. Right, still need to temper for about 8 minutes or so, but this bottle is totally empty. So I'm being ready to change to a other almost empty bottle. Keeps around 1200 degrees Celsius. Alright, so it's been tempering for 30 minutes now. It's still glowing red hot. I will shut down the propane and let this cool off inside the furnace gradually. It's cooled down. I will make some end shots so you can see the before tempering and after tempering. See you back in a bit. Alright, so it's been at least 90 minutes since I left this crucible. Still a little bit hot, but I can touch it. Right, here we go. So I can see a little change. Looks like the paint is not that shiny anymore, but you can see the spot where the flame was hitting the crucible. But if I compare this to other crucibles, you would really see a difference. So I think this is the difference in quality you can see. Looks like it's never been used before. But this one has been properly tempered. So I hope you guys like this video. If so, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to see a melting video. And the next melting video will be done with this one. So maybe someone can already guess what I will be doing. So make sure to stay tuned to my channel. I wish you a good week and see you next week. Bye bye. Mm-hmm.